Absolutely adorable.
Morning. Welcome to a new vlog. It's a new week. I have no makeup on. I'm intentionally having like a no makeup weekend this weekend. I need to wash my makeup brushes desperately. And we don't really have many plans in terms of like going out. So I'm gonna leave my face bare for a weekend because I think he needs it. If you can hear anything in the background, Joe's on his PlayStation. It's
Sorry.
Fine. No, don't apologise. It's just, it sounds like people are getting murdered in our living room, so I just wanted to make sure people know that's not happening.
They are, but they're not.
Just on the TV. I'm just about to leave the house. I'm going to go get my hair done. Thank fuck.
Get my
dude did. I'm so excited. I'm going blonde again this time because I've got my knee up in about 6 weeks or so. And it's not long enough really for me to have it done again. Or to afford to have it done again, and I won't be able to get to the hairdressers for a while afterwards whilst I'm like recovering, so I figured blonde's way easier to maintain. I don't have to worry about it fading and going like a really strange colour like it is at the moment, and it'll just do its thing for however long I need it to. Last time I left my hair for a long time, I left it like 6 months and it was absolutely fine, so I won't need to leave it that long, but it's just peace of mind for me. It means that it'll stay semi okay and it won't look like it really needs doing like it does at the moment. Then my roots are so dark, and then it goes to like pink, and then it goes to like sort of a strawberry blonde, I guess, and like all the ends just need chopping off. They're all like thin here, like from here down. I think I'm gonna get like a good couple of inches cut off. We will see, but I love going to the hairdressers because it's like the only time where I just sit and I get pampered and I don't think about anything like work or life or anything. Like, I'll go on Instagram for a bit, I'll read some magazines, I'll have my head massaged. Like, it's the best afternoon ever. And then tonight we're going round to Joe's mum and dad's, so they're making us dinner. And then tomorrow, we haven't really decided yet, we need to do a big flat clean and tidy and organise. But we also really want to go to the cinema to see Birds of Prey, so we'll see what we end up doing. Happy sad. And just like that, I'm blonde again. Swish, swish, swish. I love it. It's amazing. We had to cut quite a lot off because the ends were basically dead, but I knew that already. And I've gone really like clean, icy blonde because it's easier for me to maintain. And it's really nice, I love it, yay! And I got 20% off because my loyalty card was filled. Winner! So we've just got back. When I was in the hairdressers, there was a girl came in to have a hairdo in, obviously, and she had, I'm gonna close this door because the kettle's gonna get really loud. And she had, I don't know if any of you have a Morrison's local, but you know Morrison's have those like build your own little salad and pasta boxes. Well, when me and Joe were in, you can open the sausages, it doesn't matter. He just opened a pack of party pork sausages like really gingerly so it didn't make a sound. He's so cute. When we were in sixth form, we used to get them for lunch like all the time because our school was like a 5 minute walk from Morrison's. And I saw her in there and then I texted all our friends just like, guys, I'm having like serious flashbacks to sixth form right now and I'm craving one of these pasta salads. So on my way back I went home and got one. Went to Morrison's and got one. It's basically just a thing filled with different flavoured pasta. I can't wait. I might be getting idea. Shush! I found him! This little twat outside eating a pouch of food. It's my fault because I locked him out because I didn't see that he'd come in behind me. But I was like, where's the cat? And I opened the door and he was fucking eating through the foil pouch. You think that we'd never feed you? You're so well fed, why are you suck at him? Wise, you've been fed and you've also attacked a little pouch. You're not getting any more food. You'll get fat. He's like sniffing around. Poor Bellend. So anyway, I'm gonna make a cup of tea and then we're going to watch another couple of episodes of Lock and Key. We're hooked, aren't we? It's so good, holy shit. We've watched 5 episodes so far and it's so good. So we're gonna finish that. I look like My skin's like really pale now. I've got light hair again. I mean, it is really pale, but anyways, I'm gonna go watch Lock and Key, have a brew and eat my six different types of pasta in a state of sheer joy. My mum bought the cat these at Christmas and we've just found them. So I'm gonna see what he thinks of these catnip sardines. What's this? Come have a look. Let's get one out. What's that? I think he likes it. Oh my god. I think he likes it. You're doing the nonchalant cat thing when you pretend like you don't know where it is and then you're gonna pounce on it. Yeah, here he is. Oh, don't make it go under there.
Making din dins, making din dins.
It's very dark in here, Jo. Ooh.
You saw parts of the bog by singing there?
Apparently so, not intentionally.
It's a choice.
There we go, let there be light. Making dinner, we've cleaned the bathroom.
Making din dins.
We've cleaned the bathroom, Jo's backed around and dusted the lounge, and I think you've done the bedroom as well, haven't you?
You're so good.
Feckin' hero. So for dinner, I am making the following. This is General Tso's chicken. I think that's how you pronounce it. Forgive me if that is not how you pronounce it. It's fucking lovely. It's basically a Chinese takeaway without having to pay for a takeaway. Bish bash bosh. Here's me telling you what it is. Everyone probably already knows. But it's like chicken in like a hoisin-y, chili-y, soy saucy sauce. It's very nice. I will leave the recipe in the description because I've tried a couple and this one's definitely my favourite. We've been listening to the new song by The Used, the new song by Boston Manor. I'm just about to put on Oh Wonder's new album so I can give that a listen because I haven't heard it yet. Then I'm going to clean the kitchen and then I'm going to go for a shower and clean the shower whilst I'm in there. And then we're going to chill and maybe watch a film or a new TV show or something. We finished Lock and Key this morning. Oh, it's so good. Oh my god, it was so good. I loved it. I miss it so much already. But yeah, so that's the plan. And then we're going to settle down with a General Tso's. Maybe a glass of wine, maybe a cup of tea. We'll see how we're feeling later. Look how delicious this looks. Yes. It's all sticky and nice and it's like a takeaway but it doesn't cost as much money. Yay! Morning! It's Monday and I'm just about to go to work. I'm later than normal because the traffic was horrific because of the flooding. Our head office is in Kirkstall and it's like a main road into Leeds and it's right on the river. So we haven't flooded since Boxing Day floods in 2015, but when we did flood, our head office was destroyed. Like, since then they've put in like all the offices are on like, it almost looks like the decking that you get in like your back garden. It's just so everything's raised, so if it does flood again it might not be as bad, but all the flood defenses are on all the doors and stuff. So
we'll see how today goes and how long I spend in the office, because if it starts to flood, then I'm gonna have to go home because otherwise my car will be fucked. I couldn't get the train in to try and like protect my car because all the trains are cancelled because all the lines are flooded. So we will see what happens today. We're lucky where me and Joe live, we would never flood because we're on a slight hill. So the bottom of the hill floods because that's where the wells are. But because we're up a hill and we're also a first floor flat, we would never flood. But work is a different scenario. So we'll see. I'll just have to keep coming out and checking the water levels and make sure I can get home safe. Fun times.
Making hot chocolate. I look like really wide because I've got a hot water bottle in here. Look. We've just had a phone call with a mortgage advisor, which is exciting. It was just an initial chat, so there's no like definites in there or anything, but we're gonna meet her and we're gonna start talking about things like agreement in principles and stuff like that. But it's exciting! Yay! Houses and weddings and shit! Just made myself a hot chocolate with our Hotel Chocolat Velvetizer that Joe's mum bought us for Christmas.
It's so good!
It's so good. If you like hot chocolate, you need to buy one. I would have never thought to buy one for myself, and then Kayla bought us one and it's the best. And I make mine with Oatly Barista. Gonna take the lid off. Whoa, look how nice and velvety it looks. Whoa, yas. Look at this. Oh, look at that. It just is the best thing on earth. If you like hot chocolate, please do yourself a favour and buy one. Hi, happy Tuesday. It's horrible weather. Storm Ciara is still raging. It looks like it's gonna snow. It's kind of sleeting at the moment, which is horrible. I'm in head office all day, which is nice because it's nice and warm in there. And yeah, I've got nothing else to report really. I had a really good phone meeting with a mortgage advisor last night. And then we had dinner and then we went to bed early. Joe wasn't feeling very well last night, bless him. So we went to bed quite early. Tonight we've got to put some washing in this morning, so I'm gonna do that when we get back and feed the cat, and then we're going over to Joe's mum's. We're gonna help her wrap some birthday presents for her friend, and she's feeding us. I think she's doing stew and dumplings, my favourite. So that's fun. Then we don't really have any plans the rest of the week this week. It's a nice quiet one again. I've got the hospital on Friday morning. I've got my pre-op at 8 a.m. That's disgusting, it's so early. But other than that, we don't really have any plans apart from the fact it's Valentine's Day. But yeah, anyways, I'm gonna go to work. Goodbye.
Hello, happy Thursday. No, oh my god, it's not Thursday, it's Wednesday. It's only Wednesday. Oh my god, it's only Wednesday. How are we all? I've just got home. It is 6:10. Do you want to know what time I left work? 4:15. It's taken me 2 hours to get home from Leeds. As perspective, for people who don't live in Leeds or know where I live, like, cause I don't live in the city centre, it normally, on a normal rush hour day, it takes me about 30 to 40 minutes to get home. Today it's taken me 2 hours. I don't even know why, like the traffic was just shit. I'm assuming there was maybe like a crash or something, which is awful. I hope there wasn't, but I can't think of anything else that would explain it because it was bad in all directions. In every single way that I tried to come home, it was bad traffic, which it normally isn't. So that was just, it is what it is. I'm tired now. Joe's at the hairdresser's. I need to focus on my face. Joe's at the hairdresser's. Look how little pink my face is because all my makeup's come off. Little red cheeks. But yeah, sorry, Joe's at the hairdresser's. I've just got back and fed the cat and we're gonna have chicken burgers and chips for dinner. And I went to Aldi to get wine on the way home because I had a shit journey, I want some wine. And I saw this, which is Joe's favourite. So I've picked him up one of them. It's a Bramley apple and salty caramel crumble. So I've got some of that and some custard because I was supposed to be picking him up from work and giving him a lift to the hairdressers, but because the traffic was so shit, I had to call him, just like, yeah, I'm not going to be there. You're going to have to find another way there. He just missed the bus, which meant that he couldn't get the bus there. Then he tried to call a taxi, but because the traffic was all so bad, Uber's had like a massive surcharge on. Then he tried to call a regular taxi and they wouldn't be there on time. Then he tried to call his dad, see if his dad was free, and he wasn't free. Then he ended up getting a bus anyway, which took him so long that he may as well have just waited for me. So he's had an even worse journey home than I have. So I bought him a crumble. It's like a, I mean, I say him, it's for me as well. I'm gonna eat some as well. I love that crumble. But yeah, it's been a really shit evening in terms of like travel shit. Is Mercury retrograde again or something? Because fuck me. Other than that, I've had a really good day. Like, I've got loads done. I've had a nice day. I've been surrounded by nice people. I've had like productive hours in the day. And I've had nice lunch, and so it's been a good day apart from the end. So I think we're gonna watch To All the Boys I've Loved Before 2 tonight, because it's come out today and I'm so excited. So we're gonna watch that tonight, I think, with some wine and chicken burgers and some crumble. So that's perfect. I've texted Joe and said, do you want me to come get you when you're finished at the hairdresser's? Because I don't want him walking home in the rain, bless him. Like, it only takes 10 minutes, but when you've just had your hair done and like it's raining and you just want to get home, like, oh my good god, I'm knackered. It's Valentine's Day Friday. I'm going to show you what we bought, actually, really quickly. We were in Morrison's the other day and we just so happened upon their offer. We were going to go to Marks and Spencer's and get like a two dine in thing, because we were just like, oh, let's have a nice little cooking night, but I couldn't be bothered like actually cooking. So I was just like, yeah, we'll just get like a dine in offer. And we went to Morrison's to pick up some bits, and they just happened to have this like really cracking offer. So I'm gonna show you what we got as part of it. So to start, we got this camembert with garlic and herb sharing bread. You can't actually see the camembert, but it is in there. Like, it's in the middle. I don't know if you can see what I mean. It's like here in the middle, and then it's got a tear and share garlic bread around it. For men, we've got these sirloin steaks with this pink peppercorn butter cut into little hearts. How cute. Looks like a really nice steak as well. It's really nice and thick. Then we've got two sides. So we've got some chips and some green veg with some Jersey butter. And then the best part is the Belgian chocolate brownie puddings. But look, they are vegan, which means they're dairy free. Which means they won't hurt me and make me want to cry. So this I am excited for. Oh, and also, you also got a bottle of wine. So we've got a cheeky bottle of Merlot. All that, 15 quid. Absolutely buzzing.
Evening, it's Thursday. Oh. Banging my camera on the cooker hood. It's Thursday and I'm making some soup for dinner. Joe's in the lounge playing on his game. I've just shut the door for a bit so that he can continue listening to his music without it like being already loud on the vlog. So I don't know where my tripod's gone. I've got a little tripod for my camera and I don't know where it's gone. So it's probably somewhere in the lounge, but I can't remember. So you'll have to deal with this for now. So I'm gonna make some soup.
It's 7 a.m. and I'm sat de-icing the car waiting for Joe to be ready. We're up really early because I'm going to the hospital this morning for my pre-op, and Joe's just getting the lift with me and he's gonna go to work early and then finish early. So it's always, it's 6:52 and I'm sat in the car. Normally I'm not even awake now, so I'm doing very well. I've not put any makeup on so that I could get up like later slightly, and then I'm gonna put my makeup on in the car after the hospital before I go to work. So that's my morning. How are you? Happy Valentine's Day. But yeah, that's the day. I've got I've got the hospital and then I'm going to work and then I'm on lunch break. I'm going up to Victoria Quarter in Leeds to cuddle some puppies. I'm so excited. It's an ad, they're paying me, which makes it even more exciting. And it's for Instagram. I'm promoting, they're doing like a puppy cuddle thing for Valentine's Day. So they were like, will you come up and get some photos and we'll pay you if you put it on your Instagram. I was like, money and puppies? Yes, it's like my dream afternoon. So that's really exciting. So hopefully I'll be able to vlog some of that and you'll see the cute little puppies. So I'm gonna go now anyway because I need to like get out and de-ice my car. Fucking hate winter. Why is it spring? Hi. So I'm out of the hospital now and I'm just gonna do my makeup in the car for work. I was in the hospital for literally, I need to see my ring off. I was in the hospital for literally like 5 minutes. I think the only reason they can't do the pre-op over the phone is because, for fuck's sake, I've forgotten my foundation. Oh, no, thank God. It's because they have to take my blood pressure, which is so annoying because I have to drive like 45 minutes to get to the hospital to be in here for 5 minutes maximum. But it's fine. It's not that far from work, so I've only got like 10 minutes to get to work and it's only 8:05, so I'm gonna be super early. They didn't really have anything different to say other than last time. I had a pre-op in October because they thought that my op was gonna be in early January originally, but it got pushed back because my consultant had a lot of time off over Christmas, lucky for some, and there were a couple more emergency procedures ahead of me, so I kept getting pushed back, which is fine. So all they did was ask me a load of questions about my medication, drop my blood pressure, and that's kind of it. Like, that's literally all they did. The only thing that's changed since my last pre-op is I've since been put on an inhaler for my asthma. Now, it's a weird one because I have asthma technically, but barely. Like, I think the nurse said that my lung function without an inhaler is like 91%, so it's really not that bad. But they put me on an inhaler anyway, mainly because of this operation, because the doctor at the GP was just like, oh yeah, if we get you on this, they'll kind of take you more seriously and they'll treat your lungs as a more of a serious concern, even if it is only 91%. In short, the doctor wanted to make sure that the hospital didn't just go, no, she's saying she's got asthma, but she doesn't. So yeah, I'm going in on the 12th of March, all going well. Honestly, I'm not worried about it or anything. I had scoliosis as a kid, and I had spinal fusion surgery when I was 14. And it actually came with a lot of complications for me. It wasn't like a straightforward scoliosis operation. So I ended up spending like over 3 weeks in hospital as a 14-year-old, and I had loads of problems with my digestion in my stomach and my bowel as a result of the operation. And long story short, it was a weird one. Like, the hospital didn't know what was happening, my consultant didn't know what was happening. I was in hospital for like 3 weeks. I talked about it all in my scoliosis video years ago, so I'll leave a link to that in the description for you if you're interested. But because of that, this isn't really bothering me. Like, one night in hospital for a knee operation where the recovery is 2 weeks, that's like child's play compared to what I went through when I was younger. But I wasn't, it's a weird one as well because I was 14, like, I was old enough to be fully aware of what was happening, and I was old enough to still remember it now, like, really clearly. So it's not like I'm remembering it wrong or anything. Like, I will say that my health anxiety is going a little bit mad the closer we get to the date. Not because of the operation, but because, and I don't know if anyone else with anxiety has this, but it's going a bit mad with the what ifs. Like, what if it's not just what he thinks it is? What if it's something worse? What if this happens? What if that happens? So it's not the actual operation that I'm anxious about, it's the very small chance that it might be something more serious than they think it is once they've cut my knee open and had a look at it. And that is kind of building and getting worse towards the operation, but I'm managing it.
quite well, I think. I just kind of keep reminding myself that what happens, happens, and they don't think it is anything else. They're very, very confident that it is what they think it is. It's just, I don't have like health anxiety as such, but when I'm in situations where my health is concerned, then it starts to kind of rear its head. Does that make sense? Like, I'm not just constantly worried. Like, if I have a cough, I'm not really anxious that it's lung cancer. Like, but if I've got something serious wrong with me, so like having to go in for a knee operation, that's when my brain starts going, what if it's cancer? And I'm just like, oh my god, stop it. And I know that logically it probably won't be anything bad, but it's still tough, isn't it? I know a lot of you will understand. I've spoken to some of you about it before. But yeah, it is what it is. It is what it is. You know, I get 2 weeks off work. It wasn't made any easier by the fact that my consultant, bless him, he's a lovely guy, but he's not so good with the people skills or with the reading the room. Because when I went for my first appointment with him, so when it was, yes, you are having an operation at some point and it'll be with this fella, he was like looking at my MRI results and he was like, yeah, I think it's this, I think it's this, but you know, with these things, we never really know if it's something else, you know, it could be cancer. And I'm like, I was sat there like, sorry, what? What? And then I just had like a breakdown. Like, I got back into my car and I'd like had a full-blown meltdown. And since then I've actually kind of been okay, because I've like spent a lot of time researching what they think it is. It fits so clearly to little things like the fact that my dad has psoriatic arthritis, and the thing that I've got, I'm not purposefully trying to be coy about this, I can't remember what it's called, it's got a really long name, but the thing that I've got genetically is linked to psoriatic arthritis, which is quite a weird coincidence if it's not this. And little things like that that kind of make me go, right, it's probably this thing. But anxiety is a bitch, so we'll see. I've got just under a month until my operation. It's now the 14th and my operation is on the 12th of next month. So yeah, that's a little update on me and my health and all that. I don't really know what else to say, so I will leave it at that. Gonna go to work. Pink in here. Look how pink I look. Valentine's Day.
Yeah.
My camera knows. The light's orange, so I don't know why I look pink.
Filter for
Valentine's.
You can't even tell I'm wearing a pink top.
No, you can't. It is. So and that's pink. Not why we look pink. Anyway, it's Valentine's Day. I've already said that today, I think, but
happy say it again.
It's now 6:30 and we are home, and I'm about to cook that amazing Morrison's deal that I told you about earlier in the week, and I am so excited for some steak and chips and veg and vegan chocolate puddings. And I just wanted to show you the cards that we got each other for Valentine's Day this year. And if this doesn't show that we are meant to be, I don't know what does. So Joe got me Queen of My Heart and I got him King of My Heart. Yeah. Bless us. They are cute though, aren't they? Aren't they nice? Joe put in his Queen of My Heart, Body and Soul, ooh. And I was gonna do that, and now I'm really gutted that I didn't.
Basic.
And I was as well, and that's when I bought it, I went, ooh, and I'm now gutted that, now it's gone dark. My camera does not know what is happening right now. But yeah, so I didn't actually write ooh, and I wish I had done now, because Joe has. But yeah, it's Valentine's Day! We're gonna have a nice meal, and maybe watch something on telly, or if nothing's on telly, we're gonna play Lego Incredibles. Which is super us. And then tomorrow we're hopefully, fingers crossed, gonna go see Birds of Prey and go for a dinner at Bar Sober, which
yes.
is a nice place. Because it's our anniversary tomorrow. We've been together 11 years as of tomorrow. 11 years, cutie. But what may stop that is Dennis.
Dennis.
Storm Dennis is apparently on the way.
You arse.
And when Storm Ciara came, all the trains got cancelled. Storm Dennis is coming. And it's all very well and good if we can get into Leeds. It's whether we can then get home without having to pay an extortionate amount for taxes, which I'm not about.
Bomb.
So if that does happen, we're going to just stay home and play on the PlayStation all day instead and get a takeaway. So plan A and plan B are both really fun, whatever ends up happening. I'm going to go make tea, have some wine, and we're just going to have a chill night to celebrate V-Day. So I'm going to stop the vlog here. Because don't need to vlog that.
Sure.
Thank you for watching. I feel like this one's been better than the last one again, so we are slowly getting there. Slowly getting better and better. Eventually they'll be really good. Thank you, subscribe, like. Oh my god, I heard a story the other day, quickly, that one of my friend's like nephews or something thought for ages that by don't forget to like and subscribe was like a greeting. and his dad put him to bed and he said no night, and then the little kid said night, don't forget to like and subscribe.
Oh my god.
I was absolutely pissed off. And his dad was just like, right, that's it, no more YouTube for you. This kid's like 4. Don't forget to like and subscribe. I thought that was hilarious. The kids these days, Jesus Christ. Anyway, don't forget to like and subscribe. See you later. Bye.